观众朋友大家好，欢迎回来到了今天的嘉宾访谈环节。邓小平同志在1988年的时候说过，科学技术是第一生产力。随着时代和社会的进步，现在越来越多的这个工作都是需要很高的这些科学技能。那么在加拿大，现在这个科学学习、科学教育的现状是什么样呢？今天我们请到的嘉宾就要给我们解析一下。他们最近组织这个团体呢，做了一个报告，是叫做 Spotlight on Science Learning, a Benchmark of Canadian Talent, 如果翻译成中文就是学习科学的焦点，加拿大人才的基准。非常高兴我们今天请到的嘉宾是 Amgen Canada 事务部的总监，同时呢他也是 Spotlight on Science Learning 专家组的成员 Dr. Karen Berg. Welcome to the show, Dr. Berg.
Thank you.
So our topic today is about the report, the Spotlight on Science Learning, a benchmark of Canadian talent. Tell us more about the report. What is it?
Okay, well, the report, the Spotlight on Science Learning, it was a joint effort by Amgen Canada and Let's Talk Science, and it was a study where we wanted to look at the state of science learning in Canada, you know, where we were good and where we could be better.
Okay.
And we looked at a number of different things, a number of different measures, starting from, you know, with young children and how well they're performing in science and technology and engineering and math, what we call the STEM studies.And worked our way up all the way through university, into university, apprenticeships, colleges, and then into the workforce. And where is science fitting into all of those? And we found a number of interesting things.
Okay, and why do you want to make such a report?
Well, I think there's a lot of different reasons. I mean, but the two key reasons for why we'd like to look at such a thing is because, for starters, this is where the jobs are going to be in the future.Okay. Mm-hmm. There's a number of studies have shown that where we are in Canada right now and moving forward, say, to 2018, 75% of the new jobs that are going to be coming out are high-skilled jobs. And these are the kind of jobs that people need to have a background in science and technology and engineering studies. So if our students get that early on,then there's a number of careers for them once they reach the workforce. The other thing is that, you know, we want to make sure that we have enough people in Canada to meet the needs. We want Canada we're a good country right now. We're very competitive internationally, but we want to make sure we continue that way.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned about the current state of the science learning in Canada. How's the state? Are you satisfied with that?
Okay, well, there's a number of different things I can tell you about. So first off,Our students are doing very well. If you compare their performance internationally, our student scores are very good. We're very strong. And we're also very good in terms of our participation in extracurricular activities, like science fairs, science clubs, competitions. We do very well there. Mm-hmm. But that's at the younger levels. But then once we move into, say, the higher levels of education, into colleges, universities,What we're seeing is that the numbers of applications are leveling off. So whereas the number of jobs are growing, the applications are leveling off. And so maybe we're not seeing enough people going into further education in science, right? And then beyond that, if we look at how Canada is doing in terms of, say, really high-level education, like PhD graduates, you compare us internationally, we're actually...much worse, we're far below the level of PhDs coming out in Europe. Mm-hmm. In fact, we're even below the OECD average. So that's a concern. And, you know, where does it come from? Well, perhaps it comes from early on. Back when kids are in high school, the one thing we're seeing is that they start off, you know, when they're young, they enjoy science, they get to high school, and they start to lose that love, and they start to say itScience is no longer fun, it's no longer interesting. They're saying, no, it's hard, it's complicated, and they stop studying it. Right. And that's when they start losing the opportunities.
And what can we do to improve the situation?
Well, the report came up with a number of recommendations. First off, we would encourage to support science learning and education. Mm-hmm. So supporting our teachers, making sure that they have the tools and the resources to deliver science in a really interesting way that keeps the kids interested, keeps that love and the passion that they used to have when they were smaller. So that's a big thing. Parents can get involved. They have a responsibility as well. Parents have a huge impact in what children study and what the careers they choose. And so they can also contribute to making science something that children want to continue in. And that's one recommendation. We have many more. Another one I definitely want to tell you about, though, is the being able to better make the connection for our children about what they study now and what potential careers are. Because they might think, well, I have to be a bench scientist, or I have to do just these few jobs, when in fact there's so many opportunities that open up for them when they have a good background in science.
Do you have any recommendations for teens or children who are not really interested in science?
Well, I would encourage them to give it a try. I would say, you know what, I mean, if you love English and you love art, that's great and you should do that. But don't let your science drop just because, you know, you're afraid or you're concerned about it. You know, get to talk to your teachers, find out what they can, what are the interesting things that they're going to be doing in the class, and you know, make sure to give it a try, because it really is interesting, and it, as I said, it opens so many doors for you in traditional but non-traditional roles as well.
You mentioned about like a lot of opening jobs are very requirement for high skills. So why is it so important to create a large pool of the science-based talent, as it said in the report?
Okay, it's very interesting, actually. So a number of studies have come out recently. Manpower has done a study, and this is an international staffing organization, and they interviewed 44,000 employers across 39 countries, and what they found, they asked them, okay, what are the hardest jobs that you have trouble filling? And what they found, the number one job that's difficult to fill, because there aren't enough people who can do it, is technicians. Mm. And number three is skilled trades, and number four is engineers. So these are exactly the jobs that will be filled by people if they go on and take their STEM learning.
Right.
As well, if you look at Human Resources and Skills Development Canada, they've brought out statistics that show that in the next, 10 years, 75% of the new jobs are going to be in high skills learning or high skills area. But also beyond that, what we've seen in the past 10 years is that the wages have increased proportionally more in those areas. So, you know, it's a good job even financially. The wages, the salaries are rising even higher than the cost of living. So there's that other reason you might want to go into it as well.
Right. Okay. Another question. You are also Director of Regulatory Affairs of Amgen Canada. Mm-hmm. What is Amgen Canada, and why is science learning important to this company?
Well, Amgen Canada is a biotechnology company. We make medicines that treat grievous disease like osteoporosis, rheumatoid arthritis, cancer. So we make medicines to help people. But one of our key initiatives, which we like, to give back to the community, is we are really focused on science education. We want to raise the awareness of the importance of science literacy in Canada. Mm-hmm. And so this is one of the things we've done, is sponsor this study. We also have a Amgen Award in Science Teaching Excellence, which we give out to a science teacher, an excellent science teacher from anywhere across Canada, and this is handed out once a year. And this rewards teachers who really go the extra mile to put together interesting and fun things for their students. And that's a really nice thing to be involved in. So
it is really nice.
Yeah.
And who else is getting involved with this producing the report?
Okay, there was a number of people actually on the panel. So we had what we called an expert panel, and it was people who are very involved in science community from all walks of life. So educators from, primary, secondary, university, colleges, science policymakers, mm-hmm. industry such as myself, nonprofits like Let's Talk Science. So a broad range of people. And we got together, we figured out what questions would we like answered, and then, discussed it, looked at the data, and came up with the recommendations and conclusions.
Thank you very much for your time, Ms. Dr. Berg.
Thank you.
And thank you for telling us a little, share your opinion about the current state of the science learning in Canada. 所以说，电视机前观众朋友们，如果对这份报告感兴趣的话呢，可以登录到网址 www.letstalkscience.ca/spotlight， 上面有这个报告的整体可以下载版，大家去阅读一下，有很多非常有用的信息。再次感谢 Dr. Berg 今天来到我们的节目 ，Thank you，Thank
you very much。
我们今天的访问到这里呢，先暂时告一段了，稍事休息一下，广告回来再会。